We have arrived at last at Good Friday, Awful Friday, Extraordinary Friday, Unique Friday, Dark Friday, Liberation Friday. I can't begin to imagine how it was when darkness fell as Jesus was crucified. After the shouting of the soldiers and the weeping of the watchers, the cursing of the thief, and the awful sound of nails banging into wood, surely, as well as darkness, there would have been silence too. A whispering to one another. What is it? What's happening? A creeping fear that the cosmos was ending, when in reality, this was the beginning of its healing. There was something so extraordinary happening that nature could not help but respond. There was a deep darkness settling over Jesus' soul, which was reflected in the physical realm. He could not see the face of his mother, the other women, and John as they stood there in their final vigil. Even that small comfort was gone. Even worse, he could not sense the Father or the Spirit either. They were perhaps cheering him on for this final step, but all he could sense was the darkness and silence of abandonment. A psalm he'd learnt from his childhood echoed in the inky darkness as he gave his feelings voice. My God, why have you abandoned me? He shouted it for himself, but for all of us who across the millennia have known what it is to feel bereft of hope and of God. Yet because he was there in the darkness, God was there on that hillside then, and in the moments, weeks, months of our own despair. When we ask, where is God? We can perhaps hear him reply, here in the darkness, I'm here.